Are you ready? Let's get these cabinets level. Now we're going to do something rather spectacular. Until now, we've just raised our cabinets up to the baseline that we drew on the wall. But now what I'm going to do is set the laser level back up, and we are going to attempt to split the laser beam, which is only 1/8 inch thick, so that it shows up both on the front of the cabinets and on the wall. That's how precise this leveling system is. Okay, I want to show you. We've got our laser set up, which you can see on the wall. See the laser there? And up here, if you look here, you can see the laser is right there on the cabinet, just right, so it's lined up perfectly here. And when you come over here a little ways, you'll see that the cabinet is a little too high, so we're going to have to adjust that down. You can't even find the laser on the back wall because it's being blocked by this right here.
Keep your eye on the red line. Watch it. Watch it. Oop. There we go. Perfect. Keep in mind, when we're making these final fine-tuning adjustments, I don't use the drill. I just use a 3/16 nut driver. Keep your eye on the red line on the left-hand side. Here it comes. There it goes. We've just split that laser beam in half. Now on the right side, keep your eye on it. And there we go. It's showing up on the face, but we're a little high on our right-hand front corner. That's why it's not showing up on the wall. Let's bring it down a little bit. There we go. We have just split that laser beam on all four rails. Now we've blocked out the window as best we could, hoping that these laser beams will actually show up on camera. The thing that I want to show you is that our entire kitchen is not just level, but it is so level that we have, again, we have split a laser beam only 1/8 inch thick. We've split it in half on every single cabinet. How long did this take, you might ask? 11 minutes and 38 seconds. So, why all the fuss? Well, it's pretty simple, really. Just as you would need a strong foundation for a house, you need the same strong foundation for your cabinet system. How many times have you opened up a door or a drawer on somebody's cabinets and it just doesn't open or close like it used to? Something's changed. Something has settled. Houses settle. Wood shims settle. 100 different things could go wrong. And God forbid, if you have expensive granite in your kitchen, you definitely want a good stable foundation for your cabinets. I don't care what kind of system you use. Make sure you don't have any gaps or dips. Just get it right.
Hi, we're here today with Matt Ubelacker. His family owns Granite Enterprises and as well Busy Bee Cabinets. As you can see, they do some of the best work in town. We're going to talk to you just a little bit about the importance of a safe foundation for your granite. When you go to jobs to install granite, do you ever find it to where the granite is not installed correctly, that the cabinets aren't level?
All the time.
Really?
Where when you set a level across, it goes like this.
Yeah.
Because if there's any voids between the cabinet, and even though we shim our granite, if there's a void and somebody sits on it and there's a void there where there's just a shim here and a shim here, it's very easy for the granite to crack. Over time, you know, I guess for whatever happens, sometimes this cabinet here would just fall down a little bit, and then it would cause this to move down a little bit, and you'd get some cracking on the seam here.
All right, absolutely.
You know, and other times it's because somebody jumps on the bar top, and, you know, or jumps on the counter, and way back in the corner, they didn't shim the back. The cabinet was like this, so the back of the cabinet wasn't shimmed. And when we're doing the granite install, it's really difficult for us to see that.
Right.
If it's not level, you know, we bang on it. If it's not level, we put shims. But sometimes if it's a solid back cabinet in the corner,
right,
it's very difficult to do that.
Absolutely. When you install granite, you're typically coming in behind professional installers.
Normally, yes.
And do you see this even in the professional environment, where cabinets are not even, not plumb, not level?
Normally see them plumb, but they're not always level across the top. Like, they're, you know, they're straight up and down, but when you lay a level across them, it's a long run of cabinets. You end up with one a little lower than the other, one a little higher than the other, so there's still voids to fill when we put that granite down.
Wow.
And it's very difficult because, you know, when you shim, a shim only goes this far.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like the granite to be completely supported by all the four rails on every cabinet.
Absolutely.
That's the best quality installation you
and
have.
And it should be. But that's hard to do. With shims,
it's very difficult,
it's
to,
very
do
difficult to do. To get the backs and the fronts and the sides. That's why we invented the system.
All right, you've installed lots of granite slabs from us, from
yes.
Morningstar, that we've been using the
system.
What have you found with our installations?
They're completely level.
Every time?
I mean, every time. You can lay a level across, there's no gap whatsoever.
Thank you for that.
We don't even have to shim them.
My installers will be very happy to hear that.
We don't even have to shim them.
You know, it's so easy with the Easy Level system. It's actually fun. You know, instead of the grueling process of shimming the backs and shimming the fronts and re-leveling, it's so easy for us that it goes in a matter of minutes. Here's another thing that I see a lot. Many times when we install cabinets, we will find from one end of the kitchen to the other side, there can be as much as almost an inch difference slope.
Oh, yes.
And what we see other installers doing a lot of times is they'll stack shims up.
Mm-hmm.
It's bad enough that you have one shim, but sometimes there'll be two or three or four shims on the edge of a cabinet, and I just don't see how anybody could leave a kitchen like that. Do you ever see that?
Actually, the other day, I was doing an install, and I saw a razor knife. Somebody took their razor knife out, and they put a razor knife underneath as the shim because it was so high that the full razor knife, the one you're wearing right there, take that out.
This one
right here, that whole razor knife was sitting underneath the cabinet.
Oh my gosh. And the customer would never know.
No, they still had to put the toe kick on.
Oh my gosh.
Toe kick wasn't on yet, and I could see the knife underneath there.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, I've seen it all. That's why we invented the Easy Level system. It, you know, it's humorous to talk about it, but it's not funny at all when somebody spends $20,000 on cabinets and granite, and they're expecting it to last a lifetime. It needs to be strong enough to where little Johnny can jump up on that counter, and you don't have to worry. You know,
yeah.
It should be, you know, rock solid in the industry. We've lost that in the industry.
That's the plan.
All right, Matt. Thank you so much. God bless you. I really appreciate all your help. This has been really enlightening.
No problem. Thank you very much.
Right.
And way to design a beautiful product.
Oh, thank you very much. All right.
All right, let's finish this install. Our plans call for two pantries on the adjacent wall, as you can see in the picture. They also call for a 3-inch filler between them. So, just like all the other cabinets, first thing we did is put them on their backs, screwed the filler in place, and then we strengthened up the back with a 1x4, just clamped it together, screwed it together, and now we're ready to install that cabinet. Then I hope you enjoyed this segment installing base cabinets. Please check our website for all the other videos that we have, how to install crown, how to install light rails, lights in and above and outside your cabinets. If it has to do with kitchen and bath remodeling, we're going to have a video for it. So we thank you, God bless you, and happy installing.